Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the 5th Annual Cannabis Business Awards here in the Mile High City, chilly Denver, Colorado. My name is Bobby Black, and I am here with the lovely Chloe Villano, the woman of the hour, putting on this amazing event from Cloverleaf University, Cloverleaf Consulting. Chloe, how are you tonight?
You know, I'm feeling great. There's a lot of excitement in the room and a lot of great people nominated, so I'm excited.
Yeah, you know, as someone who has worked at and attended many cannabis events over the years, I know how much hard work it takes to go into putting together an event like this. Tell us a little about what it took to put this together, this amazing event.
Well, you know, there's so many people in this industry that do so many historic things, and it's a very hard industry as it's very new. And so I wanted to really honor those people for all of the wonderful things they've done. And then we have a private auction that is raising money for Standing Rock Resort today. So today feels really good for me.
Well, that's fantastic. You know, we've all been following closely what's been going on in Standing Rock. I personally have several friends who are veterans who went out there to participate in that, and they've told me what a moving and amazing experience it's been for them. And our hearts and our energies are with them. And I'm happy to see that Grow for Vets is here as well. Are they a sponsor also?
They're not a sponsor, but we gave them a table because we support our vets 100%. Last year we raised money for the Weed for Warriors, and so we want to show Grow for Vets a lot of love as well.
Cool. Well, tell me who else is the sponsor, because obviously Cloverleaf Consulting, which is your company, is the main sponsor. Who else is sponsoring the event?
We have Gavita Lighting, the Cannabis Business Association, Cloverleaf, the Hazy Daisy, Silver Tribe, I think is what it's called, and that's all.
Okay, so what should we expect tonight? Lots of awards, lots of drinking, lots of fun?
Just an amazing event. We have a fully sold out event here we've oversold. And so it's going to be just amazing to celebrate together.
Awesome. And these cool cannabis boutonnieres are pretty badass as well. Yes. Chloe, always a pleasure to see you and talk to you. Thank you so much for bringing me out to be a part of this amazing event.
Yes.
This lady with more brains, beauty, and balls than almost anyone in the industry, Chloe Villano. Thank you, Chloe.
Thank you, Bobby. I'll see you soon.
I'm here with Derek Cummings, winner of the 2014 Extract Artist of the Year Award, if I'm not mistaken. Is that right?
I think so.
Yeah, I can't remember which year it was.
No, I can't remember.
All the years start to blur together when you go to all these cannabis events, don't they?
That's the truth. They're like little mini reunions everywhere.
So Derek and I go way back, but I haven't seen him in a while. The last time, I should mention that we did a story together back when I was working at High Times. I did the first feature about a dab lab, about a extraction laboratory called Bobby and the Concentrate Factory. And Derek at the time was the head of Pink House Labs, and we did a whole video podcast and a story about it. A very popular video, by the way. What did you think of how all that turned out?
It became it was funny because it really, a lot of people came out. I wasn't aware it was going to become such a big deal. And now forever, people like just outside, some dude's like, you work at Pink House, right? And I was like, fucking Bobby.
Yeah, well, the amount of views that it got and the amount of comments and controversy that kind of sprung from it, I guess I shouldn't be shocked at this point that no matter what you put out nowadays, especially in the cannabis community, there's always going to be super supporters and super haters, and you know, the same thing with the different political initiatives, the one in Cali and the one here in Colorado. You know, there was big pro people, big anti people. You know, were you one of the pro people in Colorado, or were you one of the no on 64 people?
I was pro. I mean, since InHarmony Wellness, and since since the beginning of Amendment 20, it's always a push for, you know, gradual steps, and eventually you can, you know, and I say that from someone that after Amendment had my own dispensary, and after 1284 when they regulated, I lost my shop, and I'm still for regulation because I lost my shop, but we didn't lose all the shops, you know, and sometimes you have to sacrifice, and my shop literally was, I loved it. It was great. And I ran it, you know, I think it changed the standard of the way shops operated, at least here in Colorado, for certainly. And after 1284 and they regulated, you know, like some good people lost out, but a bunch of the shit show got moved along.
Yeah.
And you know, regulation's necessary in any industry to eliminate shitheads, you know, like think about how scummy used car dealers are. Like and take them and if they could do whatever they wanted and not have anybody watch what they're doing, well of course, sure. You know, like in any industry you deal with scummy people, sure. So
well, that was what was so impressive about the video that we did, I thought, because you took me on a tour of the whole lab. You went through every step, how it's done, showed the process. It was clean. It was honest. It was legit. It was sterile. It was done right. It was scientific. And that's, you know, that is what helps set the standard. At a time when so many people were open blasting,
yeah.
To go into a lab like that and see that level of professionalism, I think is what made people really excited about it. So, and now the industry is caught up, and most of the operations I would think at this point are much more on that level.
Yeah, like right now in Denver, if you're operating in hydrocarbon extraction, you're in a Class 1 Division 1 laboratory, and I'm happy to say that I moved on to Incredibles, and we were the first. You know, Brian Lucas called us and said, "Congratulations! You know, we're giving you guys approval on your laboratory and." To be the first, really not just in Denver, which, I mean, we were, but it was really turns out to be the first in the country, Class 1, Division 1, after pushing for the right thing for so long and trying to explain that, you know, like all the misinformation that gets out there about butane being unsafe and hydrocarbons being unsafe, it's just mostly a marketing gimmick by people that sell CO2 machines or CO2 products, you know, it's just... It's nice to finally be in a work environment. It's sad when there's accidents, but to compare some idiot open blasting to, you know, like they would see somebody open blasting blow up a neighborhood or their house or something, and then they would react to how they were what guidelines they were putting us in. So we ended up coming out and saying, what's the most stringent environment you can have? And it's a Class 1, Division 1,
yeah.
Flammable environment is existing all the time. Or you know, a dangerous environment. So to be able to just say, okay, let's just as tight as you can get, we can do it, and then move on from there.
Yeah.
At least we have something. Like I said, it's better to have regulations because at least now we have there's a way to do it.
Absolutely. So let me ask you. Incredibles, you said you work with Incredibles. Obviously, they've won some awards in the past, and I believe they're nominated for a few more tonight. Do you know what are they nominated for tonight?
Tonight, I think we have a best product or a best edible, one of the two. I think it's the peanut butter Buddha bar. I know we have our extract company is up. We really are proud of the fact that we have elite extracts that, because of all the other alternative routes that our extracts can go, we really only put out the very, very best in a dabbable form, and anything that's not perfect goes into one of the other 20 products that we make. So it's nice to be able to have that discretion and really be known as, man, I've never really had anything bad from them. Well, you won't, because it's only the best. So that's a nice award. It's a good honor. And I think Bob's up, our co-founder's up for a few awards. He's done a bunch of work with kids this year, so.
Let me ask you, how did winning the Extract Artist of the Year award change your career or life at all, if it did?
Well, I was already at a point where we could use that to start marketing, so. When you have something to market, it's great. You know, it's all these awards. It's one thing if you're trying to make your day about this, and it's another thing if you're able to capitalize on them. So I'm at a point where I believe there's no Santa Claus, but the kids believe so. I would like to have the stickers on the front of that packaging, so.
Right on, man. Well, Derek, thanks so much for talking to us. It's been a pleasure. Enjoy the awards. We'll see you later.
Thanks.
Greetings. We are here at the Cannabis Business Awards, which have just begun, and I am here with my friend sort of a High Times colleague, a former colleague, Rye Pritchard, everybody. How's it going, Rye?
Great, man. How are you?
good. Rye is a contributor to both High Times and The Cannabist, and also recently got involved with a show on Vice TV. Is that not, am I not correct?
Yeah, it's called Bon Appetit. It's coming out on Viceland next Wednesday, December 14th. So yeah, super excited about it. It's a cannabis cooking show, 10 episodes, incredible chefs, multiple infusions in every course. Pretty amazing stuff.
Okay, because this is a little different than the than the other, what's his name, Action Bronson cooking show, because that seemed a little bit more lowbrow, I would say. This seems like a little bit more highbrow.
Yeah, I mean, we're really trying to do innovative stuff with cannabis cuisine. We're really trying to show people, you know, the cutting edge of where cannabis is at with distillates and with different products that a lot of America hasn't seen yet. So, I think we did some stuff that's never been seen on TV for sure.
You know, I saw a couple of years ago that there was, I think it was in New York actually, there was a bartender that was doing cannabis vapor infused cocktails. Yeah. Have you guys had that on the show yet?
We had some vapor diffusers actually that were on the table when we did a very complex pairing thing. We had rigs being dropped as soon as the food got dropped, and people would take a bite, take a drink, take a dab all at the same time. It was very coordinated and timed, very cool.
So how do I get to be one of the people on the show getting to enjoy these meals and dabs and stuff?
Well, it seems like we might be having a season two, so I'll definitely give you a call.
You have my number, my friend. You have my number.
Absolutely. Especially now that you're in LA, I think it's going to be in
LA. So, you know, you and I collaborated on a piece which was The Birth of Live Resin, The Origin of Live Resin, which is an article that I'm very proud of. I didn't even write it, but I'm proud of it. You wrote it, but, you know, I was your editor, and it was a great piece. I really thought that, you know, because live resin, you know, the idea of live resin, you know, concentrates had been big for a while, and the live resin was like the new kid on the block, the exciting new product. And I fell in love with it from the minute I first tasted it. From the first moment Giddy Up walked up to me at the Denver Cup in 2014 or whatever it is and said, "Hey, man, I got something special. Check this out."
Chinese derps, bro.
It wasn't like anything I had ever tasted before. And I immediately was like, I'm a live resin guy for life. Like, this is my jam, you know, because shatter is just so, I don't know, it's hard and it's flavorless in a way.
It's cold. Yeah, it's cold, it's sterile.
It's not what I'm like. I want that gritty, I want that buttery, juicy shit, you know what I mean? So live resin to me is a godsend. But so tell us a little about the whole live resin story and how that came together.
Yeah, so I mean, I work very closely with Kind Bill, who's you know, the guy who came up with the concept and really did it first in a closed loop machine and made it a viable commercial thing. So you know, I work with Concentrate Remedies. We make live resin all the time. Actually on the show, we did a whole episode. Kind Bill was on there. He talked about the birth of live resin, and Giddy was actually on there as well, making some caviar. So yeah, live resin is my passion, man. It's the thing. I mean, just like you said, it pulls me, you know, the flavor, the aroma, everything is just so interesting to me. And it's pretty much all I care about. And now that I'm able to intersect it with food, it's like all my passions.
It's such a simple concept too, because if you're already doing the extraction of the, you know, running the solvents through the material, to do it through fresh frozen material as opposed to dried cured material, it's just such a, there's no comparison. It's just a completely different experience.
Yeah, I mean, you know, being a photographer and being in gardens and stuff like that, you really notice like how different a live plant is versus a dry, you know, dry flower. And, you know, Bill's whole thing was trying to capture that. He was in a trim room and he's like, I want my people to be smoking this as it smells as they're trimming it. And so that's where the live resin came from. And that's what we still try for. We pick the best plants. We try to, you know, bottle that essence at the peak of, you know, peak of ripeness. And yeah.
Cool, man. Well, I hope to get to actually meet Kind Bill. I've never actually gotten to meet him yet, but next time I come to Denver, hopefully I'll get to meet him. And I look forward to hopefully working with you again soon in the near future, man.
Absolutely.
It's been a pleasure.
Yeah, man.
All right. Have a great night,
awesome.
Man. Take care.
Thanks, man. Appreciate it.
Enjoy the awards. Bobby Black coming to you once again from the Cannabis Business Awards, which are raging on stage behind us. But right here, I have two very distinguished gentlemen to introduce you to. To my right is Caddy from La Sosa. Did I say that correctly?
Los Sueños Farms.
Los Sueños.
My apologies. Los Sueños Farms is the largest legal marijuana farm in the world today.
Wow, that's pretty impressive. And to my left, a gentleman I've known for some years, one of the most prominent advocates for legalization in the country, I would say, co-author of Amendment 64 and co-owner of Club 64, the one and only Mr. Rob Corey. How are you, sir?
Thank you. I'm doing very well. Welcome back to Colorado. It's good to see you here. We have come such a long way in our state.
Yeah, it's really amazing. I mean, I remember coming here for the first High Times Cannabis Cups that were done in Denver and watching that transformation from year to year. just how amazing it became. I mean, I know the event's attendance for the Cups went from like 5 or 10,000 to suddenly 50,000, and I watched the amount of people coming in, but also the amount of regulation and real effort that was put into crafting a system that works.
It is amazing, and this event right here that you're at right now, and you're at ground zero of Colorado's marijuana industry, and it is an industry, and it used to not be an industry. It used to be a couple people hanging out in Castleman's, Caddy's Old Bar, just chilling. You were there. You were there at ground zero.
Best Business Awards at my old bar.
Right. See, I forgot to mention when I introduced this gentleman that he was the former owner of Castleman's, which is the happening bar to go to if you're a stoner in Denver. I mean, no question.
It was a few years ago, but originally it started out, I met a gentleman, an attorney, Rob Corey, in 2009, simply at a hotel bar having a cocktail, who was thinking about crafting Amendment 64. Obama had said he was going to sort of back down off medical marijuana, and this gentleman here simply asked if, could I use your venue on a Monday night to sort of have a meeting, a public forum, put some chairs out, some tables on the stage, and we need to talk about what's about to happen. I said, sure, on a Monday night, maybe I'll sell some beers. 300 people showed up, you know, wannabe dispensary owners and growers and edible people, city councilmen, attorneys, and kind of all started right there.
Legit.
Goosebumps, because I mean, this is how liberty starts. The Declaration of Independence was written in bars. It literally was.
Yeah.
And this is where our movement began, you know, and this has become, and now Caddy, as he deserves, runs the biggest farm in our state, you know, and the world. Thank you.
How big is it exactly? How big is, like, can you give me a ballpark?
I can.
That's what she said. How big is it exactly?
Well, you know, what I lack in fingers, God made up for in cock size, so I'm fine. I mean, penis. Sorry about that, Peter. Anyway, so Los Sueños Farm, it's the largest legal recreational grow in the world. It's literally 36 acres of all natural sun-grown cannabis outdoor, as well as 55,000 square feet of greenhouse. We have a total plant count of 21,600 on our farm. We have 4 John Deere tractors.
Creating jobs, creating freedom, creating all kinds of opportunity. I mean, this is the vision that we wanted, you know? And I mean, these awards, the fact that it began in your bar, it gives me goosebumps to
and
be
you're
here.
Creating good karma, because the product you're producing doesn't kill people, it doesn't rape the planet, it doesn't feed large corporations, at least not yet, but
Amen.
It probably will at
Amen.
Some point.
I mean, but we are on the right side of history here, you know? We're on the right side of what is good. Genesis chapter 1 says the Lord God gave you seed-bearing plants. I mean, like anybody who's...
I use the leaves as medicine. And generally what we tell people, and sometimes we get in trouble, especially in the South when we're speaking, I sit on the lobby committee in Florida, which we just passed with a, you know, record-breaking 71.3%. If you're against cannabis, you're against God, and he'll tell you why.
I mean, and these people, they're like, well, I'm not sure about that. Well, read Genesis. It's right there.
Yeah.
But, I mean, the bigger issue is, you know, this is a legitimate industry in our state. This is one of the top 4 or 5 industries in the state of Colorado. And Colorado has become one of the leading cannabis producers in the country. California is going to catch up. I mean, they're going to surpass us.
California's got the 8th largest economy in the world, and there's a lot of people chomping at the bit to get a hold of those
30
licenses.
30 million people in California. They should.
But they
you know what? It doesn't have to. But it's not a. It's a friendly competition. It's
I
a,
hope they
it's
do. A, we want to help them as much
together,
as possible. Yes, we hope they do. We hope everybody surpasses Colorado. Our little tiny state of 4.5 million people is grown by 10,000 people a month. Why? Because we provide a product, right, that doesn't kill people, has no long-term effects, it's not damaging on your organs at all. And the children that come here, number one, how many, 10,000 people a month move here, right, Rob? There's a crane on every corner in Colorado.
Bobby Black have been fighting this for decades. I mean, you finally you have found your way to California. California is poised to become the worldwide global leader in cannabis. You're right there. You know, I'm already there. I went to Stanford Law School. I'm already practicing law out there. And, you know, but Colorado, we did jump a little ahead of you with our statewide regulation. And, you know, it was a good run, and we're still there. But I think California is going to be a major market, a major opportunity, a major place where people can access this beautiful plant and really enjoy it.
I think the most exciting prospect to me is having that wall come down between interstate commerce, and it will come down, and I believe it will come down soon, where Colorado and California will be able to share their genetics and share their products,
and, you know,
and not have it be subject to weird laws about state crossing state lines and breaking laws, you know.
And
there
legally,
needs to be an interstate commerce bill for cannabis that goes through, that makes this, because that is what will really open up the country to the, I mean, when you can have rare dankness in Jersey and in this, and then, you know what I mean? Like, it opens up the possibility for...
When the people lead, the leaders will follow. And Congress is going to do this, I predict, in the next 3 years. Congress is gonna wipe out the barriers to interstate commerce in marijuana. Already we have over 25 states, so we've got more... that we've got a majority of states that have legalized either medical or recreational or both. Also, a majority of the United States population lives in states where cannabis is legal. So the tipping point has been passed. Congress is going to do the right thing, and it's going to be very good for Colorado. And it's
pretty similar to the electoral vote.
So let me ask you.
But we win with population.
You brought up the electoral vote. What do you think the cannabis legalizations and cannabis businesses prospects are in the Trump presidency? Do you see him getting more on board the side of, hey, it's making money, it's big business, I'm into it, or do you see it more of,
yes,
or do you see Sessions being more, Attorney General saying, you know, weed is for dumb people and for bad people, and we need to curb this, you know.
As the attorney, the former. Okay, Donald Trump fundamentally is a businessman, and he's a pretty good businessman, okay? Cannabis is business, all right? Jeff Sessions, good, honorable man, works for Donald Trump, not the other way around. Donald Trump pledged on the campaign trail that he's going to respect state laws. He believes states should be the laboratories of democracy. Congressman Dana Rohrabacher said it better than anybody else, said it better than I could say it. He said Jeff Sessions is an honorable man. Jeff Sessions is going to follow his president's campaign trail promises. He said this. And I don't think Jeff Sessions is going to depart from Donald Trump's campaign trail promises. I think he's a man of his word. And we are pretty confident in our state that this is going to continue, that Donald Trump is not going to do radical, stupid things and decimate an industry that employs literally tens of thousands of people in our little state.
A whole lot more in the near future.
And it's only...
Donald Trump is a stupid speaker, but he's not a stupid man. And if Sessions decides he wants to go that route, I guarantee the wall that Donald Trump wants to build between here and Mexico will be nothing compared to the walls we built around Colorado, California, and every other populous state.
Well,
that
why pick somebody
yet.
Who's so anti-weed then if you're not expecting him to take that road?
He's not educated about marijuana properly. We as an industry, we need to go to Washington, Rob. We need to go to Washington. You know, the 10 to 15 of us in Colorado, we need to get the people from California, all the industry leaders, and we need to go educate these people, like truly educate them. And once we educate them, they will open their eyes to the propaganda that they have swallowed all these years that the United States has given us. More so, we swallow more propaganda in this country than Russia and China put together.
Yeah, it's sad. The fake news and all that stuff is sad, and the stuff that comes out of people's mouths is crazy these days. But I'm a little scared with Donald Trump in office, I gotta be honest with you. But I'm gonna hope for sanity.
One last thing about Donald Trump. If he could attend a meeting like this, I mean, 90% of the people here are dressed in dark suits. You know, I mean, this has become a legitimate industry. You've been there way before that. I know you have. I have. You know, I was the only guy wearing a suit 15 years ago, and now here we are. I mean, we're
that's why you and I got along, because you said, hey, this guy wears
exactly.
a suit.
Exactly. But
And not that wearing a suit means anything,
yeah.
but it's an indicator, you know?
It is.
And, I mean, this is a legitimate industry in our state.
And alcohol prohibition was an utter failure. Everyone knows that. Donald Trump knows that as a businessman. I mean, I think we're fine under a Trump presidency. Maybe even better, because look at George W. Bush presidency versus Barack Obama presidency. And Barack Obama is an unabashed marijuana smoker himself,
yeah.
like many times.
The Chum Gang.
Yeah, exactly. He writes about it. He didn't just try it, and he didn't not inhale. I mean, this guy, like, knows marijuana, but yet there were tons of federal raids under Democrat Barack Obama, and no federal raids in Colorado under George W. Bush. So you can't assume that just because he's a Republican, he's going to do bad things. I think we're going to be okay under Donald Trump. I really do.
Follow the money. Donald Trump will follow the money. The money's good. It exists.
Yeah.
I'm confident it's going to be successful.
Colorado is open for business, basically.
Well, Mr. President-elect, if you are watching this, I hope you can at least see the sense
Please.
In that argument. Put the tie-dye out of your mind for a moment and come see what cannabis looks like today.
Lifelong registered Republican.
Ditto. We extend the invitation to Donald Trump, all his appointees. Come educate yourself. Please, educate yourself. Make a decision after that. That's all we ask, a fair decision while you're educated.
We've got terrific people. We've got terrific people.
Well said. Right. Let's make America great again.
Let's make America bake again. We are here at the Cannabis Business Awards once again, December 7th here in Denver, a day that will live in infamy here in Denver. It's Pearl Harbor Day, as I'm sure most people know, but we have a lot of veteran representation here, which I find very comforting to see that these guys are here.
And then Grow for Vets also took the award, also for best nonprofit, so you got to give them up for that.
Yeah, for
you
sure. I give profits to Grow for Vets. I mean, those guys have been holding it out for a long time. And but let's talk a little about you, man. This is Big Sal, everybody, and he is with Buddy Boy.
I'm actually with I'm Big Sal, also known Big Sal from Denver. Check me out on Massroots, Instagram, and YouTube. I'm actually with the company Buddy Boy Brands. I've actually was nominated for MVP here at the Cannabis Business Awards. I'm also known as Colorado's Medicated Chef, teaching people how to do all their own medicine and how to make their own extractions, or if not, teach them how to do their own lipids so they can use it to infuse their own food also. I also do a radio show called Big Sal's Fried Fridays. We're doing also a video show of it. It's on also tokeradio.com. I also have a cooking show coming out called the Top Secret Medicated Cooking Show, and I'll be teaching you top secret medicated ways to infuse your food.
Wow, that's a quite a busy schedule you got there. You know, I'm freelancing it out here and out in Cali, actually, myself, and learning how to do all that stuff, juggling all these different projects. I worked at High Times for a very long time, so I was used to always working on the same stuff for the same company, and it's a totally different experience when you're on your own and you're building something,
yeah.
and you're figuring out where to branch out to next. It's exciting, but it's also a little scary sometimes.
I'm actually a person that's actually starting small, actually working with multiple million-dollar companies, and I'm actually going against some of these multi-million-dollar companies, like in some of the competitions, which is actually pretty funny because I'm already at 12 awards. I'm hoping I could actually get more. And hopefully go for a cannabis cup sooner or later. You never know.
You've won 12 awards over the past several years here, you mean?
Yes. And in the future, I'm hoping to actually start spreading out, check out more recreational states, start teaching people actually what products are out there, what products are good. I'm always telling people I'm checking it out to see if there's the good, the bad, the funky, because you don't want to be messing with that funky stuff, you know? So that's why I'm here.
So how many are you nominated for tonight?
I was actually nominated for MVP here. I've been nominated for 2 years, the last couple years, so I actually really appreciate the love, the support that I get from all of you guys.
But you weren't just nominated for MVP, you also won MVP, did you not, tonight?
Not this year or last.
Oh, you didn't.
I've just been a nominee, but you never know what happens in the future, especially with this going to be my thing that I'm going to be doing for a whole lifetime. You never know. This is a lifestyle. It's not a work thing that I do. This is my lifestyle. Getting stoned all day, every day, growing everything that I can the best way, making sure it's sticky, smelly. I like my girls, you know, I like them stinky and smelly, you know, nice and big colas. So, But if anything, if everybody wants to go check my stuff out, you can actually see some of my weed videos on YouTube. I got my weed resume, but then I also have the radio show every Friday from 3 to 5 on tokeradio.com. And if you guys are actually ever in Colorado, come check me out at Buddy Boys off of First and Federal, 155 Federal Boulevard. Medical only right now, but we do have rec stores. And if anything, ask for me, and I'll drop some knowledge on you on growing concentrates, infusions, or edibles.
Cool, man. Well, since you're going to drop your info, I might as well drop mine too. Check out my podcast, Blazing with Bobby Black, on revolverpodcasts.com. It's also available on all other iTunes, Google Play, all that stuff. But it's a stoner lifestyle interview podcast. You should check it out. Maybe I could have you on. You could have me on.
Let's do some
cross promotion, baby.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
All right, man.
Let's do this. For sure, well, let's get stoned and let's blaze one.
All right, Blazing with Bobby Black. All right, brother.
Thank you for having me.
We'll
fire
see you soon, man.
Enjoy
the rest of the night. Happy holidays. What's up, everybody? We are here live from the red carpet at the Cannabis Business Awards, and I am joined by one of tonight's big winners, winner of the Cannabis Cultivation Achievement Award, the owner of Rare Dankness, Mr. Scott Reach. Scotty, how are you, man?
Good, man. It's always nice to come out and walk home with some hardware.
Some bling,
man,
yeah.
Always.
So you're up for two awards tonight, right? Too. You're also up for MVP.
Yeah, MVP as well. But the
this is the good one.
The big one's always the cultivator. Yeah.
So have you been nominated before? Have you won before?
I think last year we were nominated for best brand or something. But yeah, this is our first award.
Oh, fantastic, man. Well, it's no wonder, man, with the facility that you guys have built here in Denver. I mean, holy cow. I mean, tell us a little about it. I've seen the photos. I've heard some of the rumors. It's beyond impressive. Tell us a little about this place, the House of Dankness.
Yeah, thank you. It's 54,000 square feet, fully automated, basically about a state-of-the-art of a cannabis production or agriculture production facility that's in the U.S. right now. Really where the automation helps us is it keeps my workforce low, which helps our overhead. So I run about a third of your typical workforce. A facility of my size would typically have 100 to 120 workers in it. I have 30 of the most hardworking guys that are out there. We'll be opening the dispensary, the House of Dankness, here in Denver, December the 16th. Don't quote me on that, but I think that's the date. It's going to be wild, man. It's one of the most beautiful shops I've ever seen. My wife did an amazing job designing it. And all the buds that we have ready and shatter and wax and all the product we have ready is way above what you typically find in your retail dispensary or medical dispensary here in Colorado.
Oh, dude, you're going to have people sleeping overnight, like for iPhones and shit, man. I'm telling you. I've seen the photos on social media of just the place going up and the place now near completion. It looks just spectacular, like Disneyland for cultivation. You know, it's I had called you because I said I'm in town. I'd really love a little sneak peek of it, a little pre-opening peek, because I'm flying out. I won't be here for the grand opening, so yeah. I can't go home and not see this amazing.
Yeah,
it's like the eighth wonder of the world, man. I love it.
Thank you. Yeah, we're really excited. I mean, as nervous as I possibly can be about having lines in December Colorado weather. we have people already booking plane tickets and booking hotels and all that. It's very humbling, man. It's very humbling.
That's awesome. Well, I know how much hard work and how much investment you put into that place, not just money, but blood, sweat, and tears, and love, and everything. And I'm really happy for you. I hope it's immensely successful. I'm sure it will be. And I look forward to seeing it, man.
Thank you. I appreciate it, man.
Well, thanks for joining us, Scott. Have a great rest of your evening, and happy holidays to you and your family, man.
Thanks, buddy. Appreciate it, Bobby.
What's up, guys? This is Bobby Black. I'm here with Sean from Yeti Farms. What's up, Sean? How you doing, man?
Having a great night here at this party. It's great to see all of our colleagues and peers here getting these amazing awards. Everybody's dressed up so beautifully. We're super happy to be here. Thanks for having us. We are so stoked to be here.
Did you ever think you'd see a bunch of wooks and stoners dressed so damn nice?
I did not. We were actually saying the same thing when we got here tonight. All the ladies look so beautiful. All the guys have got tux and coats on and everything. We're all cleaned up. Nobody's got jeans and t-shirts on tonight, so it's awfully nice to see everybody all all dressed up and in good spirits tonight.
Cool, cool, man. And so were you nominated for the stuff tonight? You are, right?
I was, yeah. Yeti Farms is a concentrate company out of Pueblo. We're all organic outdoor cultivation company. We do full plant extraction, and we were nominated tonight in the concentrate category. We unfortunately didn't get it, but again, we're working with a lot of great companies. We're just happy to be nominated and be here tonight to say hi to everybody.
No, that's awesome, man. It's an honor just to be nominated, and you know, it's sometimes it's some pretty stiff competition.
It's extremely stiff competition. Our industry has a lot of top players here in Colorado, as we all know, and with that, we're always kind of chasing each other's IP and trying to keep right at the top of the game. This is honestly all about producing the best product possible for the client, the cleanest, and keeping up with the most technology to keep everybody happy. And we're all trying to chase that same goal right now.
And what's your take on the whole hydrocarbon versus CO2 extraction methods? And what do you think produces the best tasting and the purest? I mean, what's your preference?
My personal preference, and everybody, I mean, we can get into the CO2 hydrocarbon, but we do a hydrocarbon blend of propane and butane. We get everything down to zero parts per million, so I have no concerns whatsoever about hydrocarbons. My personal favorite is nucleated or auto buttered shatter. It has the beautiful sugar taste to it. It has all the terps and all the flavor that I love. Shatter goes everywhere. It's shatter. For me, I just like to scoop that sugar up and try it with the full terp effect.
See, it's funny because when I first started doing the dab coverage for High Times, I wrote the first few dab stories for High Times, and that's what I was saying. And everybody was saying that was wrong. That was like, your shit's unstable.
No,
you know, it's like, look at it. It's melting. It's morphing. And I was like, yeah, but look at how delicious it is. It's so good. And everybody was saying you weren't doing it right, or you weren't doing it pure. And then live resin came along,
yep.
And that really cemented it for me. Like, when, first time Giddy Up turned me on to live resin.
Yeah, that's the fire.
I was like, this is what I want to smoke. Like, the other stuff's nice.
It's like licking the bud, man. You
yeah.
literally taste the full profile of the plant.
It's
no
moist.
Deviation.
It's moist and
yep.
tasty and stinky and,
yep.
oh, it's just delicious.
I love the
man.
Oily, wet, gassy
yeah.
OGs. That's really my personal preference. And there's a lot of stiff competition, like I said, in this industry now. I'm very fortunate to be able to try a lot of the high-end stuff from my other colleagues. We all share amongst each other. And the game just keeps getting better and better by the year. We're very proud to be working in it and be in the small position we are down in Pueblo.
Well, congratulations on your nomination. I'll be rooting for you next year for sure. And have a great night and a great holiday.
We appreciate everything. Thanks so much to everybody for putting this on.
All right, I am here with activist extraordinaire, the lovely Heather Manis, winner of tonight's Educational Achievement Award. How exciting! Are you excited?
I'm still in shock. I'm a little bit speechless. You never expect these kind of things. You just come and enjoy and you celebrate with your friends. But I have to be honest, this award means a lot to me because I've spent so much time out there educating and trying to share knowledge and love with everyone, and to receive this kind of award really means a lot.
Yeah, and for those of you who don't know, Heather is the president of Nature Nurse, and she's also the president of the Cannabis Nurse magazine. Did I say that right?
I'm actually just a contributor.
Oh,
Nurse
Julesy
out of Las Vegas is the co-creator and editor. We love her, and we honor her as well today. But I'm also the president of the Arizona Cannabis Nurses Association.
Right. Awesome. So, but you get around. You're living in Arizona, but I see you at all the events. You get around.
I get around in a good way. I like to put that
yeah.
in there. You got to do that because when people call for assistance, when they say, we need some education here, come help us teach these people, then you have to go. And it doesn't matter if it's in the U.S. Virgin Islands, Puerto Rico, Alaska, or California, you've just got to get up and go. And so I'm grateful that I've had the health and the well-being to be able to go out there and do what I've been able to do, because I've gained so much back from all the people that I've been able to serve.
See, and it's that kind of commitment and compassion and character that makes you such a beloved figure in the cannabis community and worthy of such an amazing award. Congratulations, Heather. Thank you so much.
Thank you, darling. I appreciate it so much. It's great to see you here tonight.
And isn't it great that our friend Eddie Lepp got released today? Isn't that
it's
joyous?
Fabulous. We're going to start seeing more of this too, now that California's gone legal and we're breaking down this stigma. And no one deserves to go to jail for a plant ever, not yesterday, not today, not tomorrow. And we're all here to make sure that that doesn't happen anymore.
Yeah, so shout out to Eddie Lepp. Brother, we love you, man. We're happy you're free. And we hope to see you soon. Maybe at the Emerald Cup, who knows?
I'll be there. See you there.
I'll be there. I'll see you there.
I'll see you there.
All right, good night, Heather.
Thank you, babe.
I am here with the man of the hour, the Lifetime Achievement Award winner, Wayward Bill, head of the chairman of the U.S. Marijuana Party and one of our national treasures in the world of activism. How are you, Bill?
I'm doing good today. I'm a very, very happy guy. Other than a wardrobe malfunction.
I don't blame you, man. Look at this. Lifetime achievement. Wow, it's pretty impressive. That's awesome. So what does one do? Did you correct me if I'm wrong. Did you beat out Willie Nelson to get that award?
I beat out Willie Nelson, Snoop Dogg, Ron Campy of MPP, and several other, Keith Straub.
Wow. That's a pretty big honor.
Yes, it is.
I think you know what your Christmas card's going to be this year, right? You holding the award, send that to all those guys.
Right.
Hey!
Yeah, you could have had this.
So talk a little about yourself, about your history. What led you to this point of winning this Lifetime Achievement Award? I know you've been a staple on the Colorado pod scene for as long as I've been coming to Colorado, which is not even that long, but...
It's a strange thing. I used to be into everything, the environment, you know, Greenpeace, you name it. I was out there for all of them. I worked for the ACLU, volunteering as a paralegal. I was working with Mason at Safer and that. And I'd always been for marijuana, you know, like I said up on stage, I heard John Sinclair speak when I was 17 years old and got hooked on, you know, his theory of sex, drugs, and rock and roll and the white youth rising up to power and marijuana. But I've been an activist since basically at 17 years old. I joined the White Panther Party, then I was sent to Chicago in 68 and saw firsthand what Richard Daley and the Democratic Party did to Vietnam War protesters. But I also heard John Sinclair speak, and it got me into believing that I could do that. Like I said, I was going along, you know, 2008 came along, I had my finger in every pie and every activity, you know, activist-wise, and I had an epiphany that I had to choose one thing that I thought I could accomplish within my lifetime, and I chose cannabis.
Well, that's smart and a heavy decision and a heavy commitment, I should say. That's pretty awesome.
Yeah, yes, it is, and I've worked hard. I'm everywhere, like I said. You know, you name it. I've been to the. I was at the hearing with Michael Kravitz for the ASA when they tried to strike it down in D.C. I've led a funeral procession for marijuana prohibition down Bourbon Street. I've been everywhere.
Yeah, that's old school, man.
I'm everywhere at everything in Colorado. You know, I'm in the state legislature. I'm in city council.
There's not too many of you old school dyed-in-the-wool activists out there anymore. I think of like some people like, you know, Steve Hager. I think of Dana Dana Beale.
Right.
I think of David Peel. I think of like just people who have just been out there doing this since the 60s, since the, you know, 50s, the 70s, you know, like part of the culture, you know, embodying the culture, right, and fighting for the culture. John Sinclair, of course, right, another one, yeah.
And it's amazing how many are still around.
Yeah.
You know, but a lot of them have passed, and a lot of them are still locked up.
Well, I just want to say congratulations, Bill. Well deserved. Nice to see you receiving some accolades for all your hard work. And we look forward to seeing you here again next year. I hope you have a great holiday, sir.
Thank you. And everybody, peace, pot, politics, or puff, puff, pass.
I'm here with Roger Martin, the founder and executive director of Grow for Vets, one of the most amazing veteran outreach programs I've seen all over the country. Roger, how are you doing tonight?
I'm doing great, Bobby. Thanks. How are you doing?
I'm doing pretty good. So you guys were up for an award tonight. You won an award tonight.
Yeah, we're the Nonprofit of the Year, so that was very exciting, very unexpected, and really appreciate it.
Wow. Well, I, you know what? It's not that unexpected to me, because I know some of the great work that you guys do. You guys providing free medicines to vets in Colorado. I know that there's so many great veteran organizations that have sprung up around cannabis now, and it's a beautiful thing to see that the vets have realized it and they've embraced cannabis as a medicine.
Well, absolutely, and thousands of veterans have told me to my face now that cannabis is the only thing that's ever helped them with PTSD, for example. Not one drug the VA shoves down their throats ever helped at all. So you're right, it's a big deal. Grow for Vets is the first one to do what we do, and as far as I know, we're still the only nonprofit, tax-exempt nonprofit organization that does it. We're having a great time. We've given away over $1 million worth of free cannabis products in a little less than 3 years. So
what is it? A vet just has to register with you and explain their situation, and then if they fit the criteria, they're provided meds. Is that how it works?
Yeah, actually, we give free cannabis to all veterans. We do have memberships too, that people can become a member, civilians and veterans. But that's not necessary to get the free cannabis that we give away.
Well, that's amazing. I don't know if you're aware of this, but I worked at High Times for many years, and I wrote a feature and did a lot of coverage about veterans and medical marijuana. I interviewed Michael Krawitz and discussed that whole issue with the paying contracts that they were forcing them off of, and I became very impassioned about it, and I started hosting all the veterans panels at the High Times events, the Cannabis Cups, and I met a lot of amazing veterans and activists through those panels, and two of the vets that I became close with are over in Standing Rock right now.
Cool.
And kneeling before the tribal elders, and it makes me so proud.
Yeah.
It makes me so proud. These men and women are so brave. It's not only brave to fight, but it's brave to endure the pain, and it's brave to heal and become whole again. That takes bravery too.
Well, we appreciate the coverage you give us. I obviously know who you are, and you've written some great stuff. Michael's a friend of mine, actually, and we work pretty closely with High Times. They had me organize their veterans panel in San Bernardino a few months ago, and I'll be doing the same thing in January at their business summit. So,
glad to see that tradition lived on even after I left High Times, because I was worried that they might not continue, but I'm happy that they did.
Yeah, well, they've been very supportive, and again, you know, people like you, you know, putting the word out and what you write and what you do here, I mean, that's what makes the world go around for us. If it wasn't for all the wonderful businesses that you saw here tonight providing us with free cannabis products, we would not be able to do what we do. So.
I applaud Chloe for putting this event on. I applaud all the nominees. I applaud all the winners and just everybody, just a bunch of great people and people who care. And, you know, you can make money in this industry and still care. It's not an either or a choice, you know.
Well, that's true. And Chloe's just an awesome lady. She's been very supportive with Cloverleaf University. In the past, she's provided us actually with meeting space where we could get together with our members and hand out our free cannabis products that we're giving away. So again, we couldn't do it without Chloe and cool businesses like hers. So.
All right, man. Well, keep up the amazing work, and we'll be seeing more of you at the events and everywhere. A pleasure to meet you,
Roger. Thank you very much. My honor.
Take care. I am here with the lovely Heather B. from Ganja Vibes. Heather, how are you?
I'm fantastic. Having a really great time at the Cannabis Business Awards 2016.
Yeah, I mean, I have to say, you are one of the more rock and roll badass kind of looks going on tonight. A lot of, you know, normally the cannabis industry is filled with tattoos and tie-dye and all that kind of stuff. Tonight's been a little, you know, little upscale, a little less so, but you pull off both very well. It's
Thank
a nice
so
mixture
much.
Of the elegant and the, I like it.
Thank you so much.
So tell us a little about your product, the Mary Jane...
Vibrator.
Yeah. I looked at it and I lost my my train of thought for a minute. Tell us about it, Heather.
Well, Ganja Vibes, the brand, is combining sex and weed in its best form ever, in a toy form where even if you don't partake in ganja, you could still love the vibes. The Mary Jane Vibrator is the world's first cannabis leaf massager, and I actually have patented it two times over in the United States, as well as one in the United European communities. So the Mary Jane Vibrator is a personal massager. It's great for all over the body use, powered by two AA batteries, and you could actually pop the egg out of it. It's a standard egg inside of a shell that looks like ganja, our love, our one and only. And because of Mother Nature and how amazing she is, it's, you know, just a wonder that this toy works so fantastically. Many, many toys are hard to please, but this one, because of so many contact points, happens to do the trick every time, and it's a great trainer for those advanced tricks.
I've heard about some of those advanced tricks. I maybe even tried one or two of my own, but certainly nothing with that.
April would love it.
Certainly nothing with
and
that.
She's gonna get one. Hey, April, I love you, girl.
All right, so honey, let's clear our Saturday night. Cool. Well, that looks pretty amazing. And you won an award for this tonight, did you not? Or were you
actually? We were nominated twice. I was nominated for Ganja Vibes. Was nominated for most innovative product of 2016. But I think it was Gavita that won the light.
Okay.
And the industry spoke on that one. You know, he is a powerhouse. All of the people that were nominated tonight are just incredible. I'm a startup company that actually just launched this year, and I'm extremely, extremely grateful to be here. And it's just awesome to be representing, because I'm from Houston, Texas. So in Houston, Texas, you know, we're really trying to legalize still, everybody. So we got to break down walls and break down barriers and make things happen as best as we can, even if it means sneaking in the back door.
You were building up to that one.
That's a new one. I've actually never said that one before.
All right. Spontaneous.
Inspired.
All right. Well, we wish you luck. Look, you're
Thank
the new
you.
Kid on the block this
yeah.
year. You got plenty. Next year, you'll
yeah.
take it, you know. And
yeah,
so
we've got a couple other toys coming out, and the lifestyle brand lives. So we've been really blessed to have a lot of support from High Times, actually, from Rick Cusick at one point, and then all of you guys coming out to the events, meeting the industry. So grateful. You know, it's all of everybody that has built this industry and just built it up so that we could all succeed at the same time. So, you know, I appreciate you, Bobby Black, because you built so much. I actually retweeted, or I Instagram a cover of Yoda Soda, also known as Tara Patrick, which caused a stir online recently, and she really supports the product as well. You know, that was from 1980.
The Tara Patrick cover. There's a whole big story behind the Tara Patrick cover. So we were throwing a ganja goddess party in Vegas, so I rented out one of the party suites at the Palms, and we set up an interview and photo shoot with Tara at the Palms, and we had her naked on a bed full of buds shooting photos for the centerfold.
Nice.
If we would have had those back then, we could have definitely gifted her one of those for sure.
We may have a follow-up photo shoot with Tara. Who knows? She really has been so loving towards my brand, and I'm so grateful for that too, and I would love it if we could all come together again in the name of Ganja Vibes and legalization and cannabis. So who knows what the future holds?
Well, me and Tara, we're good, man. We're good. Like, Tara, we partied together, so if that's going to go down, let me know. Maybe we'll do a little story about it.
Yeah.
Sounds good to me, man.
Thanks, Bobby.
All right, well, thank you, Heather. I hope you have a wonderful holiday season.
Thank you, you too.
Take care.
Thanks, Cannabis Business Awards 2016. Thank you, Chloe Villano.